In this video, I will show you how to calculate the average by ignoring errors in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have some order data containing fruits and their prices. When I calculate the average amount using the average function, I get an error because some of the product amounts contain an error. Now I want to calculate the average by ignoring the errors or skipping the error cells. The easiest way to fix this problem is to use the average if function instead of the average function. The average if function returns the average of all the cells in the range that meet the given criteria. This function accepts three arguments: a range, a criteria, and an optional average range. So let's modify the formula by typing the average if followed by an opening bracket. I will select the product amount cells as the first argument of the average if function. Since we want to ignore the NA error, I will type not equal to NA in the double quotes as the criteria argument. Type the closing bracket and hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have the average of the amounts by ignoring errors. This formula works if there is only one type of error in the cells we want to average. For example, in this Excel sheet, some of the cells contain an NA error and some value error. Since our average if formula only checks for the NA error, we will still get the value error as a result. In this case, instead of comparing individual errors using the average if function, we can use the if error function along with the average function. The if error function returns the specified value if a formula evaluates to an error. This function accepts two arguments: a value we want to check and the value to be returned if there is an error. Let's start the formula by typing an equal sign. Now type average followed by an opening bracket and then if error followed by an opening bracket. Select the amount cells as the first argument of the if error function. Type a comma and then type empty double quotes as the second error value argument. Type the closing brackets of the average and if error functions. Basically, this formula checks if the amount cells contain any error. If the amount cell does not contain an error, it returns the same amount value, but if it does, it returns the error value we specified, which is an empty string. The second and fourth amount cells contain errors, so the if error function replaced the error with the empty string value, while other amounts are kept as is. The average function automatically ignores any text and empty string values, so these values will be discarded by the average function. Since this is an array-based formula, press the Ctrl, Shift, and Enter keys to enter the formula. As you can see, we now have the average of the amounts by ignoring all type of errors. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks, and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.